week is not harvest. Harvest is throughout the whole week. And the word of God, according to the book of John 15:3, word of God is more important. That is the harvest. Tomorrow is going to be given to the poor. And on Sunday, you will join us to praise the Lord. Our prophet, Superior Evangelist Sukowade, is a dynamite preacher from Nigeria. His father was the first state evangelist for the whole Western region. So, a very good prophet and a very good preacher and a very good revivalist. God bless you. He's my brother. The Lord will continue to make you shine. When you arise, you need to shine. You are shining. You arise and shine. Of course, I want to introduce, you don't say anything yet. I want to introduce my regional. A very gentleman, very powerful for Region A, about 5 states together. I have the honor of calling my superior evangelist, Ojenadi. Please stand up, God bless you, sir. And welcome, sir. God bless you. You know, ours, we are blessed. My father in Christ, he met me by the door and he started praying. He said, "Are you going to be angry with me?" I said, "No. But you have not been here since our late pastor, Baba Joseph. He's here. Regional Evangelist, Region D. Region D. Yes, D. That is Southern State. Very powerful. Prophet, my father in Christ, Superior Evangelist Kodlani Yama. God bless you. I want to introduce my state evangelist, a very quiet and very powerful evangelist, Superior Senior Evangelist Yusu. The York State Evangelist. The largest concentration of Celestia in the Old West. God bless you, sir. And now I want to introduce my father in Christ, all the way from Nigeria. He came last year and he loved us so much that this year he said that work is not good for him alone. He said, "I have to take my wife and my daughter." And he came, paid for Yampia, for himself, the wife, and the daughter, for this harvest. Superior Evangelist, Prophet Baba Ete. God bless you. Hallelujah. Our Father in Christ's radio program and television program in Nigeria. So we are blessed to have them. They go to. You will see what will happen today and Sunday by the grace of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now I want to introduce all my shepherds. From this side, my friend, Anoduso Agba, Superior Evangelist Timothy, and our president, Kavali Bali. I want to introduce the state evangelist. I'm sorry, my friend. God will be with you, sir.
Amen.
The Lord will not forget you.
Amen.
This is my friend that my wife said, "I don't know I'm going to go to California, but I'm not going to say that now." I said, "You better buy your ticket." The state evangelist of California, the biggest state in the whole U.S. Please stand up, Superior Evangelist Abosika. God bless you. His father brought Celestia to Ondo State. God will be with you, sir.
Amen.
He shall be well with you.
Amen.
Now I want to introduce another shepherd winners, my friend. Sukiro Evangelist Oni, your winner. Please stand up for the competition. God bless you, sir. It shall be well with you. I want to introduce another shepherd from Promised Land. That is Superior Evangelist Olubi. And another shepherd of Grace of Blessing Parish in Queens, Superior Evangelist Kenny. God bless you. Now, coming to another, my brother and my friend, this is the regional secretary for the largest region in the United States. That's Superior Evangelist Sue Etama. God bless you, sir. We are blessed. Another one is Superior Evangelist Jorda from Florida. It's going to be the service conductor on Sunday. All the way from Florida. God bless you. Eri Folami, God bless you. Now, I want to introduce this, my son. They always come to say, Daddy. always call me my daddy. Oh my God. The Lord will bless you. It's a pleasure. Don't look outside, so. Time can fool you. That is prophet. Evangelist. Preacher. Golden Parish, CCC, there's Golden Parish, Alagra, to they have his own TV program, radio program. The last time I went there, he said, Daddy, you know, they just gave me 25 acres of land just for my ministry. And you already bought 50 acres before. The Lord will continue to bless you. Yeah. All these men of God, they are not just men of God, they are favor carriers. When you invest in their life, you'll be favored. Yeah. God bless you. Yes! God bless you. It's going to be the preacher on Sunday.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. If you are from, Emba, I'm going to go to here, raise up here. Cool. So, listen. Did when you go, everybody might be swinging more. Before anything, I have to appreciate God who brought me to Celestial Church. I have to appreciate God who brought me from Islam, from being Abdul Bazar to Christ Apostolic Church. To Celestial Church, the church that is filled with authenticity of purity. The church that is led by the Spirit of God, that's beyond cognitive, intellectual, extracurricular capacity. A church, say, This is the church that made me. Without Celestial, I am nothing. Back in Nigeria, I've also been telling all my Pentecostal friends that it is possible for you to see conductor wear suit or wear any clothes, but you can never see conductor wear suit. I told them, that it is possible for you to go to where they sell Katangua Okirika. And even in America, you can see people pack lots of suits and all that inside container, they send it to Nigeria or anywhere to assist people, but they have not gotten the power to pack Sultana. There's something we call paro in Nigeria called exchange, traditional exchange. You give it to the man and they give you kula or whatever. I have not seen anybody that will pack Sultana and give to them. And I told one of my friends, I said, do you know why we are not wearing shoes? Because we have the authenticity of that glory that God has given us authority to trample over snake and scorpion. Listen, he said, when you want to trample over snake and scorpion and you are wearing shoes, it shows you are afraid. But when you are not wearing shoes, you know that the power inside of you is bigger than anything created by God, because ye are God. That's why the Bible says in Matthew 18:18, whatever you bind in earth, I bind in heaven. Whatever you set loose on earth, I set loose in heaven. He now moved from there. He said in Mark 10:27, for men it is impossible, but with expecting 20 people to repeat after me. For my family, it is impossible. For my generation, it is impossible. For my uncle, it is impossible. But with God, with who? With who? With who? With who? With who? All things are possible. You better put your hands together and appreciate God on celestial, who has brought us together to take us to another level. Devil is in trouble. Yesterday we dealt with the devil. We slapped the devil. We kicked the devil. We gave the devil uppercuts. We gave the devil straight punch. But today we're going to bury the devil. Without much ado, if you don't have a good father, you cannot go far. Yes. When my daddy started talking, I call him my daddy because you know when you call daddy, you making him daddy to everybody. But when you say man, daddy, can you say my daddy? My daddy. When you say my daddy, that means my own. You are personalizing your persona daddy. Can anybody in the past say my daddy? You know, it is one daddy that will introduce you to other daddy. But before that daddy, there are other foundational daddy. When he was introducing them, I got that mind-blowing connectivity that I have all this my daddy as giants. It takes giants to give birth to giants. It takes lion to give birth to lion. Okay, now, you look at the way we're going to deal with the devil, because if the devil tried to fight only me, I got some spiritual tornado. I got some spiritual snipers behind me. So I want to show the devil that wants to confront me, because when he's confronting me, it doesn't matter. I got some people behind me. Listen, it doesn't matter anybody that is confronting you. Just look at the person that is behind you. I got the devil want to follow me when I got some superior evangelists, some powerful big pastors. How much what the devil can do? God punished the devil. You will not say amen. You will say, and his mother-in-law. Put your hands together to appreciate God. And his mother-in-law. You better clap if you don't want to cry. You better clap and smile. And let me know that I am in America. Sit down. How will I know I'm in America? Anytime an American man is clapping or talking, you're going to hear them, Okay, let me know you are in America. Oh, come on. Amen. Is that less? Is it if you're making old? in the church is part of it. It's part of it. We should stop utilizing this church. We should stop let them know that Celestial Church is the best church in the world. That's why I told my daddy. My daddy is still my own daddy at home, who gave me out to Celestial, dashed me out. That's why I now have many daddies. Jesus said, I left my father and I got many fathers. I left my mother, I got many mothers. I left my sister, I got many sisters. So I got to leave my brother, I got many brothers. So I told my dad, I said, you know what? I'm not going to leave Celestial Church of Christ. Because this church is real. Yes. Let me advise you, if you're just coming up, stop crucifying our elders. Where they are today, you are still coming there. Listen, whatever you see they do today and you're saying is wrong, what some people coming behind are still going to say what you're doing is wrong. Listen, the day we stop flying, that's the day they believe all what we are doing is right. Can I tell you one thing? Anybody coming behind you will still see a wrong thing in whatever you are doing. Because our God is new every morning. That's why the Bible says the glory of the later day will be greater than the former. So if the former is always better, what would the greater day do? What would the later day do? I want to beg you, don't let us condemn our elders in this church. Your father, you said you didn't know how to, your father didn't have clothes, but your father gave you food to eat. Remember, the money you're supposed to use to buy clothes, he used to cook the food. If you're one of those youth today and you're rubbishing them that they didn't do anywhere, where were you when the church started? Where were you when all those mama started fighting battle? Where were you when you said they got, they don't know how to speak in English, but they have the anointing to confront the devil and destroy the devil? Can I tell you, you have a picture of your future in your hand. Whatever you say about people before you, those coming behind will say, let us love this church. Don't let us condemn this church. Let us do whatever we want to do to add value to this church. I want to talk to the choir. I want to talk to a lot of people. I was reading a place in the Bible and I felt crying for myself. But I said I'm going to preach this all over the world. Celestial, if you're one of those churches after the harvest and you drink beer or you drink alcohol, you will soon die. Because God of Shaphat is angry and wants to destroy anything destroyable. I don't care whether Shaphat is here. Now I'm preaching before and you hate me. Doesn't matter. If you don't want to invite me to your church, no problem. If you don't invite me to your church, don't worry, I'll come to your house. Do you know the way I'll come to your house? One day you will just watch me on CNN and you will hear me talk. You don't want me in your church, but you will see me on the television. What is shocking, what you try to want to shock my mind not to say, I say on the television. Not because of the television, but because I have a vision. I was reading a place in the Bible. And God said, I should begin to announce that those churches and those shepherds who has always been allowing people to drink beer or alcohol after their services, all those churches will crumble. I am not cursing. That's what God told me. And I'm not lying, sir. I am not lying, sir. I came to the church. I wanted to come to the church. I said, God, do you want me to go? God said, I should fast. I said, I will fast. This is not my first time in the U.S. The first time I came to a Pentecostal church. And I preached and I told them, I am a celestial person. I'm not going to deny my church, sir. And I told them that whatever I am doing, it is just the grace of God of my life from celestial. And God said, I should begin to announce that wherever they drink beer after the service, those shepherds will serve their friends. I don't want to know how much they have given you, but you are a poor man. If you allow a rich man to dominate you in your church. Because if you are a great man of God, the Bible says the Lord will supply my needs according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Your blessing is not in the hand of any member. Your blessing is not in the hand of anybody. Your blessing is not in the hand of any choir. David said, where will my help come from? My help will come from God, the creator of heaven and earth. Stop, somebody say, I know my God. God said, I came into the U.S. in New York here. But I refuse to give them my number because many of them got shady businesses. I don't want nobody to dare in my gloom. You can go to the machine, go steal when you go money, and you want to pay tithes to me there. No. Can I tell you one thing? I'm not rich. I'm not poor, but I'm blessed. Yeah. Listen, there's difference between prosperity and blessing. If you want to prosper, God will make you prosper, but before prospering you, He will make your name great. It's not going to make your title great. That's why you don't see me tying rope. I'm not going to force myself to do it. If you don't want me to preach to your church, take your microphone. But I got to do whatever God asks me to do. When God is ready to lift you up, the only thing it's going to start from, it will start from your name. That was why He said to Abraham, and I will make your name great. He didn't make the family or the title of Abraham great. Don't forget, Abraham was 70 or 72, but he was the old fool because he was in his father's house. Not until God said, get thee out of your father's family, out of your kingdom, to the land that I will show you. If you are too connected to your family, you will have familiar problem. He now said, get thee out of your father's family, to the land that I will show you. Tell the person beside you, I want to get there. To the land that I will show you. To the land that I will show you. To the land that I will show you. How many of you want to start a new life from today? Raise up your hand. Say, today I declare myself as a blessing to my generation, not a curse, because I am blessed. Look at the person beside you. Say, neighbor, I will bless you. Stay tuned. Put your hands together, please. In answer to Abraham, get thee out of your father's family, out of your kindred. I have come to preach to my choir. I have come to talk to my daddies and my mommies here.
God doesn't love the way the water dropping from my body, because I'm going to use it to walk tonight. I told my God, I said, God, I like you because you love my family. That any day I am going to add anything to you, let me sleep and wake no more.
Amen.
And I've ever added anything since 13 years, don't let me see the end of year 2015. Yes, I'm not cursing. I am proving the authenticity of the reality. Because the only secret behind my glory is fasting and prayers. I never knew sometimes poverty needs to be in your life. Let me tell you. If my parents weren't poor, I wouldn't have been rugged. We were so poor that poor, that then there would be no food for us to eat in my father's house. If we eat rice, it would be on Christmas Day. After that, no rice again. There are some people here that knows me very well. One of my uncle is here. I used to hawk bread. I used to sell. I used to dig gutter for them. Where? Can I tell you one thing? The same place I served them as laborer, that is the same way I have my house. Listen, those people sending me errand to go and drink gutter, dwell this for them, do this for them, we are now sitting down as landlord association. Listen, my brother, there is no story God cannot change. I have not come to U.S. to impress anybody. I have not come to U.S. to preach and say, yes, this is me. I am just going to use my life as a testimony. There is no life God cannot change. Because the person sitting next to you didn't know that you are the next millionaire for the church. That is why the person is looking at me like a mashed potato and is not ready to celebrate to you. But very soon after this moment, in the next 20 days, that man and that woman that has refused to shout, that has refused to celebrate you, they celebrate you in the name of Jesus. You are coming out bigger. You are coming out better. You are coming out higher. You are flying higher. You are breaking protocol. You are breaking protocol. You are destroying the undestroyable. You are destroying the destroyer. You are stopping your stopper. The glory of God is upon you. Favor on your side. Success on your side. Glory on your side. You are the next champion. Tell the person beside you, you are the champion. And he got on stage. And I said to my father, what stopped my family
me, he will not stop me. And I started like that. Let us hold on this. If you want your life to change, four things need to change in your life. Number one, your perception. I don't know if you're going to write it down, but if you can write it down, you get the CD after the program, because we're going to sell the CD. And the way we sell the CD is going to be useful for you. Just take it home, watch it, and let them know that we are rooted in the Word. Oh, don't let me go far before anything. My friend that just left here left the fire, and I'm grabbing into the fire. So it takes iron to sharpness iron. I appreciate you, sir. I celebrate your God, sir. And we came from Ibadan, but I came from United States of Alabado. And I'm always very happy. Because as I'm saying, I don't want you to allow where you are to affect where you are going. Because where you are is just a starting point. But where you are going is your destination. Between your starting point and your destination, you need to endure the process to get to the place. Whatever you are going through in marriage now is a process about where you're going. You were disappointed by that man. Don't feel bad. It's because the man did not know your value. If the man knows who you are or what you carry, the man will not do whatever he has done to you. But the Bible says when the Lord restored the captivity of Zion, they were like dung that dreameth. Whatever the devil has taken away from you, with your thunderous amen, get it back. Say amen. You will claim it from left, right, anybody. I say, get it back. Get it back. Get your blessing back. Get your favor back. Get your success back. Get your power back. Get your anointing back. Get your glory back. Let somebody say now and say, I got it. Put your hands together for yourself if you got it. And I said to myself, I know it was so tough, that I'm going to let you know that whatever you're going through right now, listen, whatever you're going through right now is an opportunity for you to discover yourself. At times, you got to go through trouble. As a Christian, Jesus didn't say you're not going to go through trouble. He said in this world, you will face trials and tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have conquered the world. When you are in trouble, know that God is building you for the next level. Because anytime you want to go to the next level, expect the next devil. You need some devil to push you. Your friend can be the devil. The man that left you can be the devil. The man that said, baby, don't call me again. And you say, Bobo, I'm not going to call you again, but I'm going to call God. Because when I used to call you, you used to mess up my phone. When I used to call you, you need to share my word with your girlfriend. When I used to call you, you need to show yourself as if you are somebody. I stopped calling you, and I'm going to call God. I cannot call God. I call man. Can I talk now? Can I talk now? I'm going to shock you now. I'm going to shock you now. Because in the next 24 hours, you are not expecting this one that I'm talking. But the Bible says I will do a new thing, and now it will spring forth. The blessing you are not expecting. If I be a prophet of God, and I have my fathers as my prophet, I release this word to your life. Under 24 hours, receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. You receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Receive now. Sit down and say, I got it. I started like that and I started coming up. And I told God, I'm going to follow you. I'm going to follow you. I told God I'm going to follow you. Mama, no matter what you're going through right now, see it as an opportunity to discover yourself. Problem will teach you three things. Number one, problem will teach you to know yourself. Many of you don't know what you're doing until you got a problem and you discover who you are. I was not meant to be a preacher. I was meant to be a writer or a banker. But the problem was much, happens to be much for my parents that I could not go to school. Can I tell you one thing? I didn't go to university. Is that shocking? I'm going to tell you I got it. Personal development. I believe there's nothing anybody There's nothing you do that cannot do. I didn't go to school, even when I went to school, my secondary school result, I got 3B. Can I tell you the meaning for the 3B? 3B means tripartite nature of God. Because when we want to talk about God in the creation, we talk about God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So that means I got P3, I got to pass in the morning, pass in the afternoon, and pass in the evening. You want to see me now? Many of my friends went to university, but I didn't go to university. I went to the College of Adversity. I went to the College of Problems. I went to the College of Character Assassination. I went to the College of Abandonment. I went to the College of Rejection. I went to the College of Hatred. I went to the College of Calamity. I remember there was a time my mother never got no clothes for like 4 years. She got only one euro at Kuba. That was the day she was holding somebody in the church, and the person held my mother's clothes, and that cloth got torn just because of 200 naira. I remember why my hand cannot touch my shoulder. You can see this cannot touch my shoulder, and this can touch my shoulder. Why I got my hand broken in school, and my mother didn't have 150 naira to take me to Gobi. And my mother used to use me to beg for money inside the bus. Give us money, give us money. We don't have what to eat. We started Babian La, we started begging for money from the bus. And they will be abusing my mother in my presence. What will I do? And when I grew up as a remnant packer. I would go to where they are doing party, and I would pack remnants. I would tell them we want to go and cook for our dog. We didn't have dog though. The remaining bone and fish inside pieces is what we will cook at home. Every Saturday, if you see me looking for newspaper, I am not a newspaper reader. I am looking for obituary where they will see people inside that say they want to have party as soon as lady. I go there, I do bus conductor, I will carry remnants. You are laughing, but my parents were crying. I got to give you hope this night because we want to pray. And I'm telling you, I'm only building you for what I'm taking you to. So if I now add anything to my God, it is to rob me and kill me. Because what I'm gaining now, I never deserved it. The power, the grace, the gift of prophecy inside of me, I didn't work for it. Oshoka did, Oshoka struggled for it, all my daddy struggled for it, I just jumped and started eating. Then I would be a bastard to begin to condemn my fathers. Can I tell you one thing? It was so rough that in the family, everybody abandoned my parents. I am coming out to shock you with a testimony. There's one man they call Kolita Ira in Nigeria. I happen to be one of those that served him when his house was building his house. The day they drove me out of the house of the uncompleted building, I was unable to carry bricks. That was when they sent me out. But like 7 years ago when they came to our church, he said, Dede, he says, oh, and now Akbar, he's so lot of crowd, he's so lot of cars, he's so lot of people. And that day, when he came, my security man said, you cannot see him now. Go and stay outside. He said, I'm coming, Kolita, and you know my partner, they're mad in the head. Can I tell you, you need to be mad? Can somebody say, I'm mad? Louder, say, I'm mad. Louder, shout, I'm mad. If you are not mad, you cannot be made. If you are not mad, you cannot be made. You need some kind of spiritual longevity to become great in life. With your thunderous amen, you will be great. I say you will be great. I say you will be great. I say you will be great. In the name of Jesus. It was so tough for my parents that I told my mother, I am going and I'm coming back to bring the glory. And I am the glory of the later day that will be greater than the former. And my father, when I came into Celestia, they started waging war against my father, and my father said, let him go. Maybe that's where God asked him to go, and we're going to see the results he will bring back. My father said this yesterday, the only thing that can terminate your result is your insult. I mean, your insult is your result. When people are insulting you, let your result come. Your result will terminate your result. Your result will terminate your insult. Tell the person beside you, stay tuned. You will soon know why. Now I say stay tuned, you will soon know why. Shout and say stay tuned, you will soon know why. Four things you need to observe if you want your life to work in new dimension. Change your perception. Whatever you see about yourself is what you will experience. When I was so rough, I just shot my story and I called it short and I'm going to continue from here. Some other time I will have crusade or whatever. I'm just going to use the word to build some people's faith. That's not where we're going. You have to connect yourself to where you are going. Embrace the picture of your future. Don't let people destroy where you are going. Don't let them condemn you that you are nothing. Don't let them condemn you that you cannot make it. Don't let them condemn you that that is the end of your life. It is never a crime that no somebody left you. When a man should leave your life, another man will come. When a woman should leave your life, another woman will come. When a business should leave you, another business will come. I release this word to your life. Anything the devil has taken away from you because of this harvest, I release you and get it back. Your perception, the way you see yourself, determine what they say about you. If you see yourself that you're going to be great, you'll be great. If you see yourself you're going somewhere, you'll get there. If you see yourself that this problem cannot swallow me, it will not swallow you. If you see yourself that you are not dead, but you are alive, you will be alive. If you see yourself that you are a protocol breaker, you will break protocol. That anything that is disturbing them in your family will not disturb you because your case is different. I don't know whether your mother suffered, but you will not suffer because your case is different. I don't know whether they don't get papers easy on time in America. You will get your own because your case is different. I am expecting 40 people to join me and say my case is different. Your case is different, sir. Your case is different. Your case is different. Your case is different. Your case is different. My daddy, your case are different. Your cases are different, sir. Look at somebody and say, my case is different. Louder, my case is different. If they die young in your family, your case. If they have diabetes in your family, your case. If they go up and come down, your case. Oh, I am expecting some people to scatter this place and say my case is different. So now, I know what I'm talking about. This church, our case is different. I don't know if any church is not doing well in America, but all our churches and parishes in America, our case is different. Slap somebody up and say my case is different. Anytime God is ready to do new thing in your life, hello? Anytime God is ready to do new thing in your life, He will bring a problem. Every solution about our life, about your life, is wrapped up in the problem. Anytime you want to go to another level, expect a problem. John 16:3 says, in this world, you will face trials and tribulation. Be of good cheer. I have conquered the world. Look at it, when I hear the word of God and I look at whatever God says, I don't know that I know that I can never doubt the word of God. He said, I have conquered the world. That means you have seen the battle, but I have conquered. You have seen the situation, I have conquered. You have seen your story, I have conquered. Do you know why you need to obey the word of God and embrace this? Anytime you see any word that comes out, know that God is not a liar. Then let all men be liars, but God is honest. You know why? God said in Numbers 23, verse 19, God is not a man that he should lie, and not a son of man that he should repent. As he said it, and don't do it. Anytime you hear the word of God, consider three things. Number one, the source of the word. Where is the word coming from? Number two, the integrity of the speaker. Who is this person talking? God. Number three, the authenticity of the word. Anything that comes out of the mouth of God is always real. I speak the word to your life. If you have the most longest amen, it is your time to testify. I say it's your time to testify. 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 Slap somebody up and say, my tongue. I have 2 minutes to go now because
You have been seeing people in this church and they are making money. Tell them, Kumara. If anybody is buying houses at Miami, anywhere before you, tell them it doesn't matter. Somebody get the paper before you say it. It doesn't matter. Somebody is giving them $10 million in this job. It doesn't matter. Somebody got 2015 LJ Cruiser. It doesn't matter. Somebody gets Lamborghini 2016. It doesn't matter. Somebody man got married before you and they went to Las Vegas for the wedding. It doesn't matter. But the Bible says the glory of the latter day shall be greater than the former. I said to your life, it is your turn to testify, your turn to make million, your turn to get your paper, your turn to get your million, your turn to get your glory, your turn. Jump up and shout yes.
I feel like running off now, I'm going to let you guys go. It doesn't matter. Your perception. Number two, your confession. What you say with your mouth is what you will achieve.
The secret of my life is somebody should give me a message. Eh, how many of you? Even Ari, 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 oh, we did it. You know some prophets now, they are not really you. If they want to give you a message, they will now start different style. They can start from Fuji again. Oh, no, 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 you know how they will cook their story. And you know that they don't have anything. If they want to give you a message, they will use question to ask question. How? They will use songs. How will they use songs? Kilomba, Erukowi, Eruko, Simu, welcome. If you know it's great, don't believe it. By assumption, Baba, no, Tony, Erumba, me. I am afraid I won't come. Not even my mother. They want to drive me. Look at somebody say, yeah. Yeah. God will change this church. Yeah. When somebody says to your mouth, and he says you are going to die, with your mouth you say, I will not die, but live to declare the words of God. Am I talking to anyone here now? Somebody say you are not going to be prosperous. You tell them I will prosper. Because the Bible says in the book of 3 John, above all things, I wish you prosperous and be in good health as your soul prospereth. If Jesus prosper, I must prosper. If Jesus is blessed, I must bless. If Jesus go higher, I must go higher. Oh, Lord, Mumiga, Emi no aga. Oh, Lord, Jesus, Emi no malo. Oh, Lord, Mumiga, Emi no aga.
As a matter of fact, I don't want to see you. Keep your money. Whatever you got,
you got to do right, I can love you. Because by the time I said, okay, everybody, go and meet your husband and kiss now. Two women now kiss you. And when we hear
that, imagine, it is good not for a man to be alone. And God said, I'll now give you a helpmate that will help. So when God gives you your wife as your helper, place value on that woman. Because when God created you, he was afraid. That's why the Bible says you are fearfully made. But when he created woman, he said they are fearfully and wonderfully. And I talk to everyone here now. So if you are a man and you are calling your wife differently, you are the same thing. If they ask you, where's your wife? You say, ah, that foolish woman. You are a foolish man. Because it takes a foolish man to marry a foolish woman. Am I talking to anyone here now? Am I talking to anyone here? Am I talking to anyone here? You are saying, I want to change my wife. Because my mother, my wife does not know how to speak in English. Change your grandmother not to speak English. This woman, because of you, is using Medicare products. Because of you, she's using Perfect Finish. Because of you, she's using Brazilian hair. Remember, your grandmother, she did. Remember, this woman that you say is not beautiful, she will sing song. Good song for you. Oh Lord, me. Oh, amazing me. Already. Stop. Wait, I'm coming. Listen to me. But remember the song your grandmother sang. Say, you remember that song? Remember, that was your grandmother's song. And you are now trying to want to change your wife. Oh, that demon inside of you, I command you to go up by fire. Yeah. Number two, your confession. The Bible says in Romans chapter 12, verse 2, be ye not conformed to the world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Can I hear you shout several times, I am a champion?
$60,000. I'm not going to go far. I got my card here. I'll tell somebody to send it to your account from home. But if you
want me to be your friend,
I'm going to tell you the truth.
If you don't want me to be your friend, let me be.
I love you when I'm alone. That I'm alone does not mean I'm lonely.
I can be alone, but I'm not lonely.
How can I choose my father as my father? Because he's not married to two wives.
Listen to me.
I am telling him this for the first time in my life.
I don't know. Trust me.
I cannot be short. And my mouth will not be big. They will chase me.
I know I am short. If anybody that is tall want to come back,
you will go back.
If I do short, only Kerala. Only my team is Kerala.
I want to be one way either. No guru, me or Tobi. Matua Dake. Have I Jimmy Way?
That is why I don't go to Agiju
in Lagos. I don't do it. I don't go to stream. I don't believe in it. So if you are going to it, no problem. Go and stream. I believe in the second Corinthians 17. If any man be in Christ, is a new creature.
Hallelujah.
Come on. I don't know what you're going to do in this stream. I don't know. You can go to me. You can stop me from Celestia. Celestia belongs to God, not you. You can't sack me because you're not the one that employed me. The person I'm employing is God. I am telling you the way I am operating my church that we are over 3,000 members. And we do two services. If they are not full, we are not going to stream. That's why they are staying. Do you know why you don't have to go to stream in our church? Because when you go to a stream, somebody is bathing one junction. He's using black soap to bath. He's using something to bath and cursing. Hey, all this thing as it's going, let it go. And that water is going towards another place. You will now enter that river. Baba, put it. What the person is bathing away is what you are carrying. Instead of you to go down to that, why don't you go to swimming pool? And tell the devil you are a liar. You are too small to take me to the stream because I am going to the pool. When you get to the stream, you cannot swim. When you get to the stream, you can bath. You cannot swim. But when you get to the pool, you can swim. And the meaning of swimming, you are putting behind your problem. I am swimming, I am putting behind my backwardness. I am putting behind my hatred. Can I see you swim now? Put it away to some people. I am swimming to my next level. I am swimming to my glory. I am swimming to my promotion. I am swimming to my husband's house. I am swimming to the next one of my wedding. I'm swimming! Listen, I can't go to the bush. Because listen, if I should pray for someone now, and I don't know their arm robber, and the says, go and look for a short man that has glory.
That is why any man of God that is praying for a madman must not close eyes. As I'm short, I will not follow them to the bush. They will be looking at my head.
Don't worry, it's a big play. This head serve as you get shook for this side. You good if they serve out now. I said,
God, instead of being to take them to the bush, give me word. The Bible says he sent his word and he healed them. I said the word of God for your life. Under 24 hours, receive your testimony. Let your amen be sharper. Receive your testimony. Receive your blessing. Receive your glory. Receive your power. Let somebody say, I got the power.
And I started preaching. And I started saying that we don't need to go to the stream. We don't need to go to the bush. I don't know whether you go to stream in America. You go to stream here? Oh, why don't you go to stream? Go create one stream now. Obama will just throw you home. Create stream. Great, swim. From 105, 710, 8 years, I don't know what. I started from the street. I'm not gonna lie to you. I've been there before. I'm not gonna lie. I started. But I now said, God, I don't want analog spiritual life. I want digital.
I want miracle instant. I don't want go and come. I want them to see it now. Because when Jesus was going and Bartimaeus said, Jesus, the son of David, have mercy on me. Jesus said, what do you want me to do for you? He said, I want to see. And he said, he gave him the miracle. The woman with the issue of blood didn't go to sleep. The woman said, from the touch the hem of the garment, I shall be made whole.
And she touched the hem of the garment. But many of you are so proud that you cannot touch Baba Adebonju's garment. Because why? You all are strong. You are in America. I am going to tell you why many of you are not prosperous. You are too familiar with your shepherd.
And the Bible says, touch not my anointed. See, the anointing you don't respect, don't expect anything from it.
Yes.
All right. That's
the truth.
That's all. I am not talking because I am talking for my father. If you are a man here and you are being rude to your shepherd, you are not a man because you have not built a mansion. I can call you a man if you have built a mansion in America. Not all the houses you buy in America you build in Berlin.
I know all. Darling God, you got 2015. Ranger Sport does not mean I'm going to kill myself. I know you got a deal. I'm going to pay for 5 years.
And I know what's going on here. That's why I'm going to tell you the truth. Can I talk?
Youth in this church, if you are not up to 40, please, I want you to see this evening. If I am a carrier of people, financial tsunami that your family has never experienced, if you can say amen and scatter this place,
Get it in the name of Jesus.
Some of you need to change your location. If you don't change your location, you will end up your life in frustration. God said to Abraham, get thee out of your father's family, out of your kingdom, to the land that I will show you. If you change your location, your manifestation is guaranteed. If you change your location, your system is changing. If you change your location, your style of life will change. Do you remember some of you left Nigeria and you changed your location? That's why you are here and you are making it. If you cannot change your location, you cannot change your allocation. The last one, change your association. That's why I'm going to stop now. After now, you just need to pick up your phone, look at your contacts. Anybody that's not adding value to you.
Some association needs to change. I am connected to you, my fathers, because I know your destiny and your coming and your anointing can help me. That's why I'm associated with you. I am celebrating you because there's something to celebrate in your life, sir. But if there's nothing in your life, I will never follow you. Because nothing cannot follow nothing. It takes nothing to follow something to become something. So that's why the Bible says, iron sharpens iron. As a man sharpens the cantaloupe of his strength. Any son that wants to go higher, we have to climb on the shoulder of his father. And when he climbs on the shoulder, he will see father. When he sees father, he will be ready to fly higher. When he fly higher, he will go far. Change your association. It's not, it doesn't matter whether you have too many friends. You got one friend is enough. That's why the Bible says two are better than one. Indeed, they will have a good report. Any friend that is talking about some other people about you, delete that friend. Because the friend that is talking about you, another person about you, will still talk about you to another person. If you are telling me somebody says something about me, I will ask you, what did you say when they said? Are you clapping now? Change your association. This is where I'm going to stop. I want you to go back to Beijing and start a new life. I would have loved to teach you an article of gratitude to the game. I got something about acts of gratitude. But when I came in, God said, I need to change it. Change your association. I'm in Nigeria. I'm going to leave the church to tell the one who said, I'm not going. The whole of my diary, I got a lot of programs. Redeem Church. After I went to Redeem Church, and after administration, I was going, they gave me dollars. I thought it was just small money. I counted it, the first money, $10,000 in Nigeria. The man asked me to come on Wednesday. I went there, big man. He said, Lily, I like the way you minister. You didn't minister like a celeb. I said, I'm a celeb, I can't deny. I don't know whether there's camera there. And Nigeria, small team, you'll see yourself inside paper.
me the camera. Inside his office, he said, you are not on camera. I'm a celebrity. I was sitting there, I saw the camera with him. I'm a celebrity. He just gave me one thing. I said, I just have seen zero. Sir, I made that just in one day. The first money that followed, 10 million. The old woman inside the car said, the man was preaching and he gave me the hope of my life. That he wanted to go pay tithe somewhere and God said he should give me 10 million. Amen.
Can't you make the woman out like you can't give me God 10 million? You will change your association, sir.
And anytime I get to the church, I will just sing Baba Aniwa Akati. You will not see people rolling on the cloud. They are not wearing this cloud. They were in Celeb before.
And they will roll.
And I say, yes, I want the new one.
I will like, if I tell you, hey, yeah.
I say, yeah, together today.
Who are you moving with?
With the time of what goes with you. My daddy, ladies and gentlemen, you can see my Bulldog doing well. Look at his association. You can see Johannes Abayon doing well. Look at that association. You can see Bola White doing well. Look at their association. You are there, you are saying they are Alashwara, they don't serve God. Do you know God? If you know God, poverty will not be in your life. Because anybody that knows God must know the sources in God. Poverty is not part of salvation. He said, seeking for the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all joy, all others, Christian, houses, in Florida, Miami, everything I will add. So if God has not added it to you, check yourself. Who is your association? Who you move with, determine what moves with you. Change some people out of your life and your life will change. Change some people out of your life. Change the people you talk to. Change what you pray for. Change the people you have in your life. I have 2 or 3 pastors in Nigeria that anytime I see their call, I must call them back. And when the same man calls you, they must call me back. Why? Because I can sharpen it higher. You know when it is when you go minister in somebody's church and you are going with 5 million naira, and you go to his church again, you are going with 7 million naira. Do you have a friend that if you want to break down, the friend will be good? Is it not a friend that if he's going out of you, will go down?
Your association will determine your acceleration. If you want your journey to be faster,
move with good people.
If you want your journey to be smooth,
move with people that have got a smooth destiny.
Move with people
that can change your life permanently. I met someone, I've not seen the person before, the person from the UK, but one day she was giving me a testimony. This woman is 60 years of age. Atorishe knows this person I'm talking about. When this woman was looking for me, she got my number from Atorishe. This woman, when somebody wanted to pay her money, the first tithe they gave that woman, £4 million. And we calculated it was 1 billion naira. Sir, Miss Shekolu.
Yes.
You know, what is wrong with us? You didn't talk. Can I talk to you?
Yes!
I'm a bad man, see. Mommy, could that be a woman?
It's not good for a woman not to eat the fruit of her labor. My mother suffered and now she's eating the fruit of her labor. And that's why I want to pray today that I'm not against a joke. Change your association. Change your confession. Change your perception. Change your location.
And you will experience manifestation. Let us get on.
Let us pray this first prayer. Lord, separate me from ordinary people.
Listen
to me, listen to me. My daddy, wait.
Sir, I can't take permission from you now. Let me take from our grandfathers now. You know me, are you? You just say my son, over. And I said, daddy, over. You know when your father said over? You mean walking, talking, over. Yes, sir. 3, 2, 3, 2, over. And I know the ATM. Can I tell you the ATM that can get money from God? Can I tell you the number?
Yes.
Let me give you the pin number now.
Yes.
I should give you Lotto, yes. That you make money.
Yes.
tomorrow. You want to play?
Yes.
Okay. Bring out your Bible.
And therefore, be a big shame on your Lord. Bring out your Bible. If you don't make that money by Monday, no, I'm not called. And if you make that money, please pay your tithe to this church. Bring out your Bible. Father, in the name of Jesus, go and take no talk, no quickly. And you have been using me all over Nigeria. Bring out your Bible. Write it down. Let me give you know. This is not the time to joke. This is not the time to joke. Put your Bible on your paper. Put your Bible on your paper. My father, they want to try you to me. I am God. Are you ready? Are you ready? Number one, J E S U S. That is the number. That is the number. Call the number tomorrow. You got the result in the Lord. He bring out his food. I got it. Amen. Now this is the time I want to pray. Don't let us joke now. I want you to pray that we sweat. It's gonna be five prayers. I'm gonna let go. My daddy, I am taking permission from our grandfathers. I have begged them. They should let me do the assignment on Sunday. Abisa.
Yes, sir.
I know this time. Can I get up? Thank you, sir. Daddy, I love you.
I will love you
my life. Because a lot of people are coming to see what we got in Celestial Sunday.
Yes.
And you have given me the word. You have given back to me as a lion. Let me go fight. And bring the result home. Daddy, I appreciate you, sir.
Yes, sir. We appreciate you too,
sir. Sunday is going to be mad for the devil.
Yes.
We have been having harvest. But this time around, it's not going to be dancing. After the victory and the miracle, we'll now start dancing.
Yes.
See, nobody will teach you that you don't need to spray money. When big money comes, you will not have $100 again. Do you know why you are still praying $1? Because you are still poor. You are still poor. Leave that thing. If you are rich, spray $100, one bill. If money comes, sir, you will not spray it. You will ask, sir, I am dropping $50,000 to this church. See, you know why? I went through a lot in my life. That's why I said it's out of myself. Anything I want to do, I want the best for myself. I want to be the best food. I want to live the best house. I want to have the best car. Before, I came, Daddy, you are called. I came into this church the first day. Ask Shatira, I told him. Hey, look, what does that come to me? Nobody alerts is on my phone. I got into this church. I said, God, am I sent here? He said, yes. And I showed alerts. 10 million naira from Nigeria. I just started. I know God will not be working. Because if that person should call me and say, ah, we are sorry, that thing cannot. I said, Rujo, God, I'm not sent here. I go back home. Immediately, sir. We were eating. Mother was at the corner of the house. Every Musa. The one they call it, give you a good name. Read the right book. You're a people of me. Yes, sir. Don't ask me my glory. Ask me my story. I want you a lot. I'm going to teach you some other time how I went to the prison. Yeah. When I started the ministry, I went to Korea. Recall me. They got the money all over the world. I'm a preacher. I got it. I went to the beginning. And when I got in there, I delivered many people. I came back out of the prison. The landlord, that is Tim, and the rock. He was a setup for my lift up. That was when I met Buddy George. And you know what I said about nobody touching? That was the way I met Mustafa.
What?
If I tell you I know Mustafa, you know what it is? If I tell you I know the new IG, you know what it is? Some people need to push you to your destiny.
When they are doing it, they don't know they are doing you good. But the Bible says in Romans 8:28, everything working together for good.
For those that love God and to those that are called according to his purpose. Whatever they are doing, let them do it.
Everything is working together for my
I don't want it there.
That's where I got it and I remember some people always pray when they're in the prison. Please, anybody that will help me outside, let the person have a problem that will bring him here.
And when I got in there,
I brought a lot of people out. I got in my last book, my latest book is Be Unstoppable. The first day I launched the program, the book, Ghana, that came, a lot of people came. I printed my book with 400,000. The day of my launching my book, I made 5 million. People were not many. You don't need too many people in your life. You need to set a standard, sir. I told you, no one imagine, I said you are rich. You better keep up on those pray money. I told you yesterday, attitude of gratitude. Don't do eye service. If you come in, I begin to sing.
Instead of that, humble yourself before God. Bring the money to church and donate. Leave the stupid money you are spending.
You may not like me, but we got to kill the tradition. Because I've been to a lot of Pentecostal church. I will tell them, bring out 10,000, bring out 50,000, bring out 1 million. They write check, they drop, they just pray. And after the service, yes sir, and after the service, the shepherd, the pastor of the church will call me and begin to pray for me. They will pray to the point of trying to want to swear. If I am lying, call my baby, this will be. What happened when I went to this church? Call him and ask. I wore my shatana and I'm not afraid. In our church, I'm sorry, Genesis, we don't spring money. And we are richer than churches spring money. Because with 2-3 hours that we're supposed to do crusade, do healing, do prophecy, somebody will be dancing from outside. He said, yeah, man, I'm a laga. Yeah, I don't say that we're gas, so I don't have to do laga. I don't tell what we need. You will not put the money inside the prison. You will not begin to dance. Above all, that boy that's supposed to be a mega star will now be praising man inside the church.
Yes.
After singing, Mama Rosie Mobarode, anyway, Ray Mobarode, Kalebu, that boy will have gone out to drink. With his ear, he will put your ring as a man. You were here when I disgraced Shaquille. That boy, I disgraced him. I didn't tell him I was coming to disgrace him. Because by using your ring, very soon you will advance, you will start gay. I mean, any man that is using your ring is not a man. Don't because you want to satisfy people, pastor, tell them the truth too. The truth you don't tell them is what they are getting in Pentecostal. And when they get there, they will not come back again. Because they are giving you money, you can't say the truth too. Help the money they want to draw.
Yes,
why will people stop talking about white garment church and we are growing and crazy in dirty things? I don't care who you are. If you got power and you say you are anointed, try me in 3 days if you wake up. Let's see. But I know he that is in me is greater than he that is in me. My daddy, I'm not saying you should stop eating your church. I am only talking to we youth that are just starting our church. We. I'm sorry, Sal. I'm glorifying to you. Hi, John. And you have a show. You will not be okay. What am I saying? I went to Akala Tura. Papa sees the church. They donated money. They didn't spray money. Ah, my dear, my mommy, my daddy, I want you to understand that this world is not ours. We are just here for a little period of time. We are going when the time comes. Good. Have you watched TDJs in the church when he's preaching? Did you ever see them spray money? And then we call $10,000, people will come out. $50,000, people will come out. They are not spraying money. Why are they more blessed than us? Because our attitude of gratitude has got to do with eye service. And there's nobody that can worship man and gain anything from God. They will call Alaja kuti tigeo, alaja mi, alaja alaja alaja, alaja mi. He will be nice as allowed to dance inside the church, and because of the money you want to get, remember you are digging the grave of your destiny. I have sent my word. You may not call me back again in your church. If you don't call me here, some other pastor or shepherd will call me to their church. All I know, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. I have come as a preacher to speak the truth, to let you know. Now I am living here. Daddy, it is time for us to begin to take care of our choir.
Yes, sir.
No more. Thank you. I pay, sir. All my instrumentalists in my church, I pay salary. Ask you. The least person that collects money there now is 70k. Call them in Nigeria. And I have more than 200 people in my barricade. All my instrumentalists are on salary. And I just pray to God. I want to start paying them in dollars now. Sir, I am a teacher. I am a coach. I am a preacher. If you want Celestial to grow, let us re-strategize and leave energy. The Bible says in 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9, by strength shall no man prevail. That is why we are struggling. You don't need to struggle when you do the right thing. When we can have vocalists, we have a lot of people in the church that even if they are walking, encourage them. They are not far from the altar. They need to eat from the altar. Finally, let me come back to you. Do you know why members are crawling? Because your shepherd is suffering. Even if your shepherd is a billionaire, you still need to be a blessing to him. Can I tell you one thing? I am not on salary in Nigeria, man. No church is giving me money. But the money I get for my members, I have a group in our church. They call them Israel Group. This group, all of them, they're not more than 15. Their money they pay through their group to me. Every month is 500k. And how would I wake up and operate? With the money I see, apart from my book, every month I see more than 1 million. I have not touched that in the last 3 years. How can anybody now want to stand against my member? Every Wednesday to Friday, I know you too. I fast for my members. If I say it's in our church, I love my members, they will say, I love my shepherd. Because we are too connected to each other. If they are sleeping, I am awake. I am saying, this person must not die. This person must not die. We are 3,000. We must be 4,000. We must be 3,000. It's because they are taking care of me. And this is not your fault. It's because you are not told. Now I am telling you, God sees my heart. I am not framing this. If this man has ever told me this, let me not get to Nigeria sin. But if you didn't tell me anything, and I'm telling you that some things we need to correct for the church to fly and those are stop crawling, we have to change something. How many people have we helped in this church? Do we have any departments that assist people? That's what we need to do with church money. There are percentage that will share. Do you have widow in this church that you are giving money to? Do you have people you are giving scholarships to? How can Obama know us? When are the whole celestial in the whole world in America, when have you gathered money and go to a charity and donate that money in the name of celestial? Whether Obama will not know you. After doing that, Obama will recognize white coming. We have kept ourselves behind because what happened to us are doing and you are running them down, they are flying. When they are talking about Obama rally or whatever rally, when they are talking about gay or no gay or any rally they are doing in America, when have all the semester in America, when are you going to wear the whole of your sutana and you will be on American road? People will get paper. They will not get paper. Stay at home. Will get paper. Wear your sutana and start singing. Wait. All cameramen or Igbo will come. Yo, what's up? Well, you got such a people, my God, they are angels. Obama will look at you, they will look at you on CNN. Yes. Sir, I cannot be in America, they will not know me. If they don't know me, I will look for trouble. If they do what I say, Obama, you are not correct. This gay thing you are talking about, you are not supposed to say. I know I gave paper. I mean, So Obama, you know what? I will tell you, you're going on crazy, you know what? I'm challenging you as a prophet of God. You're doing what God said you can do. You know what? You don't do it again. I'm celestial. Celestial. Yes, celestial. No, celestial. Obama will hear. Let us change our mentality and our taste will change. Sir, if you are a member of this church and you are not taking care of your shepherd, you cannot succeed. I'm not lying. I'm not. If I want to bring it out of the Bible, it's going to be crazy here. If you're not taking care of your shepherd, even if it's richer than this, you're not helping me. Look at me here. He paid my ticket, not that I didn't have, I told you, sir.
You want me to come? Buy my ticket.
I'm just trying to want to make you laugh.
Please, I am saying this because I want to know, let you know what it takes to take care of your shepherd. How many of you want to change your mind now? God, this is a new dawn at Queen's Parish. And I love you, Jesus, because you want to take us to a new level. Take care of the choir. Take care of the elders. Let us move away from tradition. Let us give to God. Above all, my sir, let us take care of our shepherd. Let the levels change. Even if he's a millionaire, he has labored. Let him laugh. Point at him, say, Daddy,
Daddy,
we will take care of you. See, this is not a matter of show. Let us pray now. Father, separate me from ordinary people. Sir, I have just given you this word. If you want to pray, pray aggressively. When you watch our church on YouTube, we pray like Pentecostal.
Because Jehovah, Jesus Christ, only Michael. He got his shed and you better know.
Ephesians 6 12 says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities and rulers of the world. Matthew 11 12 says, the kingdom of God sovereign violence, and the violence taketh it by force. But when you go, where you are, my daddy, tell your man, name your last one, or your no more job. Yaja, my daddy, if someone should have ordinary people in his church, ordinary friend, ordinary wife, I will talk about that. It's not for a man of God to have ordinary wife. Your wife must not dwell on candle and to rally. Your wife must be a mega super mother. Because if she's not a super mega mother, members will not respect her. She's the only. My wife will not be begging your mother. Mommy, my wife will be like, if I shake my eyes, she will run. Am I talking to you now? Let us pray. God, separate me from ordinary people. My mommy, please, don't look at the way I'm going to laugh. Let us be serious. Let us change our mind. Let us change our location. Let us change our perception. Let us change our association. Lord, change me from ordinary people. You will pray Jehovah, Jesus Christ, only my God. Change me from ordinary people. Say, I'm having a prayer. Change me from ordinary people. Change me, separate me from ordinary people. In Jesus' name, we pray.
I like your spirit. You are very young, but I like the way you pray. Emma will be much about Darusi. Hold yourself. Two people. Two people. Face yourself. Hold yourself. Lord, remove me from same sin.
Lord, remove me from same sin. Oduwa, your mikro di no back or no. Be moje wa the last year. Lord, the butuwa last year. But then go in theiri, ijo wo in theiri mashe. If you pray more than that person, you are leaving there before that person. Open your mouth and pray. Remove me from sense bolas. Every spirit of Samson, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray. Look at me. Say after me, evil voices. Crying against my sources.
I silence you.
You better pray because they are watching you from home.
Mommy, God wants to fight for you. Don't fight again. God said, I will make by a toy for you. And God is making you cry secretly. He wants to make you laugh by it. Because he said he's going to fill the mouth of your mockers with shame. And when they have abandoned you, they will say the glory. I can see you investing into this harvest. You have sold, you will eat. You will read that before. Because God said to me, you have never enjoyed what they call, I enjoy husband from the beginning. You have been the man in the show.
You are playing the role of a man and playing the role of a woman. Listen, you know why I'm saying this? Because God has made you glory on the later day that's not going to be greater than the former. But that's what I'm praying. God said, in the next 21 days, He wants to make you laugh. Because the Bible says, the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. And to do prayer, you just be thanking God. Because I can see you in the first phase about this harvest. And I can see you sowing. And God said, she has sown, and you will give it back to her. And I'm going to tell you something secretly. It's not going to be for public consumption. But you be thanking God, and I'll tell you why you're thanking God. I know your mind is telling me, hey, if there's any other secret, let him tell you the secret. Is that true? I want to tell you now. Let's say, some of you, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to tell you openly. I don't care. Yeah, I'm going to tell you openly. And some of you, I'm going to call you secretly. Because I'm a prophet, I'm going to say, yes, I'm going to need your Ororo come at $1. Sir, I am not here to joke. I am here to pray that God should do something. My money, everyone here under the sound of my voice, if you can jump, if you can say amen and jump, you will go faster. 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 In success, in blessing, in glory. We are going to take it again. The Bible says you will run and overtake, and you will possess your possession. Father, everything we have not received from January, what month are we? What is the number of this month? And the Bible says in Psalm 138 verse 8, the Lord will perfect that which concerns me. Philippians 1:6 says, who has started a good job in my life shall definitely perfect it until the day of Jesus Christ. I have come to announce to you with your biggest amen, God will perfect your marriage. He will perfect your marriage. He will perfect your blessing. He will perfect your papers. He will perfect your glory. He will perfect your health. This time around, I want you to say 21 amen and run and jump in the name of Jesus.
Sir, he shall call the woe. I have just given you my testimony.
When God is ready to bless you, it doesn't matter whether you are at home or not at home.
Olorunwanile.
Olorunwanile.
Let's go.
Selera ma fi don go si.
Mo mu awon ri yen o je mi data. So pe ikan ti won pa ni pe awa lo bi si sele. Baba ma lo koko be.
O mata. Iwo ni koko be. Se mo bibele so ogo ikeyin. A ko ni so aju lo. So pe ni ko pe ko mara.
O mata.
That's what says.
Olorunwanile. Olorunwanile ya jo. Olorunwanile so. Olorunwanile.
That when I'm at home, money is entering. In America, money is entering. At night, money is entering.
If you are blessed, at last will come midnight. Sometimes my account manager will just call me from Union Bank. Hold it up. You don't land me. My name came out. I'm not touching that. Because I can't invest in my future. I want to be a great father to my parents. I mean to my wife and to my children. I want to grow old, but if I grow old, I want to die before my wife. As I said, so, I'm a man. A real man should be able to stand for the family. I don't want to see my wife go down the grave before me. I want to grow old. I'm going to grow old. Like 100. That's how I'm going to handle. But I'm going to leave my wife behind. And when I'm going down, they're going to sing for me. Because I'm going to flashback. All I've been doing for her every birthday. All I've been doing for her about kids. I've been able to transform the family. I want to die and remember for something. I want to die and be a blessing to my generation.